بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us life and tawfiq to be able to sit in this blessed gathering insha'Allah ta'ala, and seeking only the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reading the works of the ulama. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them good in this life and the hereafter. So we were reading, barakallahu fikum, from the usul sunnah, was the sharh of Sheikh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, ayyadahu Allah wa nasara, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him, grant him victory and assist him, ameen. And this is from the work of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah, in his tremendous work that is Usul al-Sunnah, that many scholars, barakallahu fikum, past and present, they have given the explanation of this tremendous work, even though the size is very small. But walillah alhamd, the benefits, and the benefits is tremendous, barakallahu fikum. So we reach the point where Imam Ahmad rahimahullah mentioned about fighting, or yani fighting the one that is a thief, assailant, or someone that is attacking an individual for his wealth, for his honor, for his wealth, for his life, and for his religion. And likewise, killing or fighting the Khawarij, it is permissible. Either fighting the Khawarij, it is permissible. So Imam Ahmad, he mentioned, وَالْقِطَالِ لِلْلُصُوصِ وَالْخَوَارِجِ جَائِزِ, that fighting the thieves and the Khawarij, meaning the rebels, it is permissible. He say, إِذَا عَرَضُوا لِلْرَجُلِ فِي نَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ فَلَهُ أَنْ يُقَاتِلْ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ, that if the person is at risk of being attacked, طيب, if he is at risk of being attacked, whether by his person, or because of his person, or because of his wealth, he say, فَلَهُ أَنْ يُقَاتِلْ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ, it is for him, meaning it is an obligation for him to defend himself and to defend his wealth. وَيَدْفَعْ عَنْهَا بِكُلِّ مَا يَقْدِرْ, and he will fight off the assailants, he will fight off the predators, for by any mean possible to fight them off. He say, وَلَيْسَ لَهُ إِذَا فَارَقُوهُ أَوْ تَرَكُوهُ أَنْ يَطْلُبُوهُمْ, it is not for the individual that is being attacked to be, barakallahu fikum, if the thieves or those who attacked him, they run away or they went away from him and they left him, طيب, it is not for him to be chasing them out. It is not for him to be seeking them out or pursuing them. He say, وَلَا يَتَّبِعْ أَثَارَهُمْ, and it is not for him to be looking for them, to be investigated, to catch them and the like. He say, لَيْسَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا الْإِمَامِ أَوْ وُلَاتُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, it is for nobody to be investigating or to be looking after them or to be running after them or to be chasing them except the one that is the imam. Here the meaning the leader, طيب, the leader. And likewise the one that is of authority among the Muslims. وَإِنَّمَا لَهُ أَنْ يَدْفَعَ نَفْسِهِ في مقامة ذلك, في مقامة ذلك, في مقامه ذلك, it is only for the person being attacked to fight him off. طيب, to try to fight him off, meaning at the time and place where he is being attacked. At the time and place where the person is being attacked. But while doing this, he say, وَيَنْوِي بِجَهْدِهِ أَنْ لَا يَقْتُلْ أَحَدًا. And while he is fighting off the assailant, or the يعني, a person that is attacking him, the intruder or the like, while he's fighting him off, that his intention is what? It is not that he is to kill him. Right? He is fighting off. He is fighting him off just to free himself from being harmed, or for his wife from being taken, or for his life not being yani, taken. But he is not having the intention to kill him. He is just defending himself. But he is not having the intention to kill the individual. He say, فَإِمَّا تَعَلَى يَدِهِ. He say, فِي دَفْعِهِ عَن نَفْسِهِ فِي الْمَعْرَقَةِ. He say, فَأَبْعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمَقْتُولِ. He say, if the person die in his hand, meaning if the intruder or the assailant, طيب, he died in his hand, meaning he died in the hand of the person that is trying to defend himself and trying to defend his property and the like. If the person die at the time that they are fighting one another, he say that فَأَبْعَدَ اللَّهُ الْمَقْتُولِ, that the person being killed, meaning the assailant or the intruder or the attacker, he will be far away, removed from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنْ قُتِلَ هَذَا فِي تِلْكَ الْحَالِ وَهُوَ يَدْفَعُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ رَجَوْتُ لَهُ الشَّهَادَةِ. Imam Ahmed rahimahullah say in his beautiful words, he say, and these are beautiful words, but yet they are words of principle upon the religion. He say, if the person that is defending himself or defending his wife from the attacker or defending his family from the attacker, from the intruder, from the assailant, he say, if he die in that situation while he's defending himself and he is killed, he say, Imam Ahmed, he say, رَجَوْتُ لَهُ الشَّهَادَةِ, that I hope, or we hope, that I hope for him that he died in the state of martyrdom. He died as a martyr. كَمَا جَاءَ فِي الْأَحَادِيثِ وَجَمِيعِ الْآثَارِ, as it came to some of the narration and as it came to some of the athar. Sometime, barakallahu feekum, the ulama of hadith, they can mention the hadith and mean by it the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when they say the athar, that this goes back to the sahaba. It goes back to the statement of the sahaba. But when they mention the athar in one wording, it can, barakallahu feekum, mean the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faqat. But if they are mentioned like this, they are mentioned, yani, in one sentence they are both mentioned, then everyone will take a statement on its own. إِذَ اجْتَمَعَا افْتَرَقَا. If they are brought together, they will mean different. But if they are brought separately, they could have the same meaning. فهمتم؟ Let's مثلا. أحسنت الإسلام والإيمان. What else? Another example real quick. But this different. Because here the salah, well, this is different. Any other example? No. No, al-Islam al-Iman. It's easy. Huh? No, meaning two things that are different. You know, salah and zakat, they are different. Salah and zakat, they are different. No, this is in the istilah. This is in the istilah. No, not even that. But two things that might have the same, they might mean the same thing. But if they are brought in the same wording, at the same, in the same sentence, then everyone will take something different. مثلاً المسكين والفقير. مسكين and فقير. If they are mentioned differently, in a verse where only the miskin is mentioned, it also takes the ruling of the faqir. But if they are mentioned, إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءُ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ. Now, it is to be defined what is a faqir and what is a miskin. مثلا, a prophet and a messenger. النبي والرسل. If they are mentioned together, barakallahu fiqh, it could mean, it's different, meaning who is a prophet and who is a messenger. But if barakallahu fikum, they are brought together, barakallahu fikum, that it could mean that everyone is taking the place of the other one. Shuf. So therefore here he mentioned, so therefore, the athar, when is sometime it is mentioned by the ahl al-hadith, the athar could be the statement of the sahaba, aqwalu sahaba. Mathalan athar, and you have some books that are written, Athar Abu Bakr, mathalan. The statements of Abu Bakr, right? Or the Athar Umar. You have those compilation where it only brings about the statements of Umar, radiyallahu anhu. Tayyib? I'm sorry? No. Yes. But when they are mentioned, it is specific. Same thing, Islam and Iman, Mu'min and Muslim. طيب, if they are mentioned, if you say the Mu'min, it carries the Muslim. If you say the Muslim, it carries out the believer. Except that Barakallah, they brought together, and then their meaning will be different in this. But ala kullin, na'am. But that's different. This is to it's a proof that al-a'mal min al-iman. Al-a'mal min musammayat al-iman.
So one was mentioned, but it took on.
No, the one that is mentioned is to prove, right? That because here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. That Allah is not to be wasting your iman. But here, when you go to the books of tafsir, it is the salah, because it was regarding to the al-qiblatayni. So here it is different, because here it only means the issue of al-a'mal in regard to the iman. How iman and action, barakallahu fikum, they are something that as ahlul ilm, ahlul sunnah wal jama'ah, they believe. So here he mentioned, so the point that we wanted to make is here is what? Is the issue of the statement when he mentioned, he say, and kama ja'a fi al-hadith, as it came in the hadith. So here, when we say the hadith, it the statement of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa jami' al-athar, and likewise to many, yani other narrations. Tayyib, narration here, athar, could mean also the statement of the sahaba that would be raised up to the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he mentioned, wa jami' al-athar fi hadha, innama amiru, innama, he say, wa innama, he say, أمر بقتاله. He say في هذا إنما أمر بقتاله. But now here, what is being addressed? What is being made an obligation? What we have been يعني commanded? He say بقتاله is to defend himself, not to kill him, but rather to defend himself. He say ولم يؤمر ب يعني ب ب ب ب ب ب بقتله. And it is not made upon him to kill him. It is not being commanded, jazakallahu khair. It is not being commanded for him to kill him. But what is being commanded upon the person being attacked is what? To fight off the individual. Not to have the intention to kill him. That gotta be clear. So he mentioned here, walattiba'ihi, and not to follow him, to run after him. Not to run after him, or not to yani pursue him and the like. So he mentioned here, if now the individual is being barakallahu fikum, yani captured or subdued, tayyib, and if he is barakallahu fikum, yani being wounded, if he is wounded, or he is being barakallahu fikum, yani subdued, or he is being captive, walaikum salam wa barakatuh, it is not for anyone to kill him. And it is وَلَا يُقِيمُ عَلَيْهِ الْحَدِ. And it is for anyone to establish the legal punishment. It is not for anyone. Let's say he is wounded. He run about a mile and then he, you know, just collapsed because he was, you know, maybe the individual stabbed him, or he gave him like a good sucker punch and he's, you know, he fainted.